Amen. El hemasech alo taselach. Erchag amatzot tishmor shivat yami. Amen. Ufeter chamor tifdev ese vimlo tifdev ara. Baruch Adonai Hamvorach.
Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Leolam Vaed.
Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Leolam Vaed. Baruch Atah Adonai. Shabbat Shalom and Chag Semach, which means Happy Holiday. The holiday I'm referring to is Sukkot, Feast of the Tabernacles. The Hebrew word Sukkot is plural of booth or tabernacle, which is after Moses carved the two stone tablets God inscribed in the Ten Commandments. My after is from the book of Ezekiel, chapters 38 and 39. This is a special reading for the Shabbat, which is in the middle of the holiday Sukkot or the Tabernacles. Ezekiel was 25 when he was carried off to Babylon, along with thousands of other Israelites. The second lesson was, despite the fact God was so angry with his people, he was still merciful in the end and wanted his people to have their own land and watch over them.
That's right.
On September 28th, I did the ride and had a blast. After the ride, I even did the ice bucket challenge, which actually felt great. Not only was it fun to ride with my dad and many other people, but I felt really good because I knew that I was making a difference in people's lives. The whole organization raised $190,000, which brought us one step closer to finding a cure for ALS. My dad and I raised $4,000, and our team raised over $11,000. I would like to start off by thanking Rabbi Boaz for leading this wonderful service today. Thank you for your insightful guidance in helping me really understand my Torah and my Haftorah portion. Thank you to the cantor, Jackie, for her constant kindness and encouragement over the past 6 months as my bar mitzvah tutor. Thanks for always believing me, and of course, your beautiful voice today. I want to thank all my grandparents, aunts, uncles, and cousins. You guys always know how to put a smile on my face. Thank you to everyone that has traveled here to be with me today. I appreciate the effort that you have given to be here and to celebrate my bar mitzvah with me. Thank you to all my friends that have been supporting me along the way and to become a bar mitzvah. I want to thank my very special big sister for always caring about me, always making me laugh, and being the best sister any brother could have. And last but certainly not least, a very special thank you to my wonderful mom and dad. They have always encouraged and believed in me. They have taught me to always work hard and to be the best that I can be. Thank you for taking care of me and helping me become the person I am today. Thanks to everyone here. You made a huge impact on my life. Shabbat Shalom. Emevat Sedek. Al Atarah. Ve'al Havodah. Baruch Atananai. Mekadesh HaShabbat.
Ethan, your mother and I are brimming with pride on this day as you've become a bar mitzvah. We have witnessed the many hours of study that have led to this day, and we couldn't be more proud of your accomplishments. I can't wait to ride with you next year. Congratulations on this wonderful milestone, and we look forward to sharing many more of these moments in your life. We love you.
Said that.
Please rise for the closing benediction. Shavuot Tov, a good week. Chaim Tovim, a good life. And Mazel Tov, and our service is now.
Sitting down preparing to write this, a lot of thoughts raced through my mind. Obviously, there's a sense of relief. The planning, the day are finally here, but it's a little bittersweet, as most parents can relate to. This will be yet another momentous occasion that will be behind us. I kept on coming back to the people, and as I delved deeper into Ethan's readings more and more, it really got me thinking about life in general. And now I can tell you I'm one of the least religious people that I know. And it really, when I was digging into Ethan's part, Ezekiel 39, I was like, this is pretty deep stuff. And God really wanted to make a point. For those not familiar, I'll spare you the gore and details, but appreciation and thankfulness is what I was left with. I started to do a mental inventory of all of you, every one of you here in the room, and I thought about what each of you means to my family and I. And I was truly humbled. When I looked at each one of your virtual faces, I realized how much each of you has impacted us in so many ways, and this goes back a long time. I'm not going to go over all that each of you has done for us, but I can only say that I'm gushing
with sincerity when I tell you how blessed I am to have you all as family and friends. You've all been there for the births, the laughs, the good times, and most importantly, the difficult moments. We treasure each of you and thank you for being there for the Sussman trip. As has been mentioned, Ethan and I participated recently in the Ride to Defeat ALS. And it's something that neither one of us will ever forget. But one thing that stuck in my mind is the generosity that was exhibited by all of you and all the people that donated to our cause and supported us all the way. It has really made me look at people in general through a different set of lenses. The human spirit is alive and well, and despite what you see on the news at night, or all the bad things that you see going on in the world today, I have a different perspective. Lastly, I would like to say how blessed I am for my two precious kids and my wife. My journey would be nothing without Deborah, and this event was truly her making. Thanks to you all for coming, and have a wonderful evening. That's all.
guess it's a long way to go, but in the meantime, before you cross the street, take my hand. Life is what happens to you while you're busy making other
Good night, Sean.